Aha! We travel the waterways. Is this old guy still up here? He's got. Oh. Oh, see? I don't even know we can get through here. How may I help you? The special concert will be held at the International Theater, says McBean. All of you are invited since you saved Cavaro. Here's your concert ticket, says Forte. Are you serious? I'm so impressed. I've been feeling uneasy lately because I feel like the people of Cavaro treat us coldly. Oh, I wonder where that would be. I'm happy to find out that it is not that they are angry toward us. Oh no, huh? Anything else? Okay. I thought we couldn't get into this second section area of the map at all. But that is not the case. Any soldiers hanging out over here? Oh, this guy at the end here. Sure. It's so boring to be a gatekeeper. I don't have any luck at all. Here's your ticket, says Una. Alright, I'll be there. Well, you don't have to guard the gate, says Forte. You're right. It's gonna be ugly if the wood soldiers come to attack when I'm away from my post. I'll pass this time. What is this way anyway? Marcha. Alright. Alright, so, who else? We gave to you, right? It's gonna be extra special. All the better to kill you. Okay, so maybe that's it? Maybe that's all now? Maybe now we got them all? Maybe. Oh wait, this is the way to the embassy. Resident officer says, I didn't expect this to happen. Commander Xenon, what a cruel human. I can't believe he released the wood soldiers in Cavaro, ordered his men to get rid of them, and is making a favor for us. The soldiers in the 7th Division seem not to know that Commander Xenon released the wood soldiers. Some of the soldiers are victimized, too. We shouldn't tell anyone about this. It's settled already, as Aria is the culprit. Guardsman says, okay. Oh, you are? Hello, soldiers, says McBean. How are you? The special concert is going to be held at the International Theater in appreciation of saving the city from the wood soldiers. Are you going to perform? Says the guardsman. No way. Cavaro's International Theater is not for the likes of troubadours. It is actually for the real musicians to perform. We're just a barker. Here's your concert ticket. Forte and his friends handed over the concert ticket. Concert ticket, huh? I have to guard here, so I probably won't be able to go, but I'll take it anyway. Thank you. You know what? If you need a visa to Numeros, you should go apply for it now. Because you don't know what's going to happen from now. Huh. Really? Invitation, huh? I don't deserve it. I wish Captain Palman was with us at a time like this. Alright, awesome. We got to go in here. Just look around. Is there anything else around? Any more soldiers? Nope. No books? Hello. Greetings to you. What are you doing at the Embassy of Numeros? If you don't have any business, please leave. Only authorized people can enter now. McBain says, the special concert, yeah, blah, blah, blah. The Diva and the Cavaro Trio. Since you invited me, it wouldn't be bad to go for recreation. Good idea, says McBain. Oh, I almost forgot. Rio Troubadour is on a tour and thinking about stopping by at Numeros eventually. Can you issue a visa for us? Oh, okay. You couldn't apply till now because of the martial law by Commander Xenon, huh? Sorry for the inconvenience. No, no problem. I'll issue it right away. Let me see your passport. They handed passport to the resident military officer. Let me stamp permission here. Now you have everything you need to enter my country. Forte and his friends receive a Enter Numeros. Well, says Forte, Letteratudo, Graysol, Pensola, Marcheros, and Numeros Empire. Una says, we've already received the visa for Buridane and Letteratudo, so you're right. We have visas from all the countries we need. It'd be nice to go on a trip freely without being tied up with one country, says the officer. Oh, says McBain, that was the last ticket we have. How is the preparation of the theater going, says Una. Let's go check it out. Awesome. So you're traveling around the world while performing? I'm so jealous. I'm hoping someday to travel at a slow pace, not as a part of my job in the military. Yenin? I'm not going to check around this time, because we've been doing that continuously. I am going to check all around the theater, though. Whoa, cool, says Forte. You're awesome, Altos. That's Altos, all right, says Una. Palman, truly, is magnificent. Captain Palman, you're back, says McBain. Did you figure out the getaway route? From Polka, Edel to Cavaro, we're under the Numeros occupation. It's impossible to escape from Polka. Escaping toward Marcha in the west will lead to a mysterious prairie area, which is said to make people get lost. Mysterious prairie? Says Forte. According to the locals, someone has seen her around there. She may be familiar with the area. I see, says McBain. So you think she could escape by her own ability if we escort her to the area? Yes. Sounds right. I'll trust your hunch. We will head to the prairie. Now let's go upstairs and discuss this with the mayor. We're not going to be here for the concert? That is unholy. Altos is someone who can boost up his talent by making great efforts. In that way, he is similar to Balthazar. I am not equal to Miss Aria, but I'll do my best. I can't believe you could acquire such a difficult part in such a short time. You amaze me, Altos. While he looks at us. Whew! Somehow I managed to reach the point where I can receive permission from Wolf. But I can express only half of what Wolf taught me. Of course, Wolf says. If you can perfectly play it after a short practice, you will bring shame on me. I think you did your best. You'll be ready and enter the stage. Good work, says Una. Squeak! Somehow he is getting a hang of it. Now I can return the favor to Aria. Luna says, "We distributed the invitation tickets to the numerous soldiers." "Thanks," says Ms. Maritos. "Now we're done with our preparation. What's left is only the musicians." Balthazar says, "Sorry for the delay." Mayor DeMille says, "How are you guys doing?" "Not perfect yet," says Wolf, "but it's doable. I can give this boy a passing grade." Thank you very much," says Altos. "Don't get so intense," Wolf says. "Just try not to keep others from performing well." Keep others from... How would he do that? McBain says, "Okay, let's review our operation procedure one more time. Please make sure that Commander Xenon is in the theater before you start the concert. It doesn't mean anything unless we trap him inside." "I see," says DeMille. "Once the concert starts, we'll sneak in the City Hall and rescue Miss Aria." "Oh, that's right. The concert starts, then we do it. Okay. I'll come along with you," says Palman. "Thank you. Please do. You two, Mayor DeMille and Ms. Maritos, please keep observing the concert from the position where Xenon can see you. He's pretty smart, so if you guys aren't there, he will sense it." "You'll feel more comfortable if we are around, right?" says DeMille. "We can do that." Maritos says, "We can even start fighting if you want." "That might be a good idea," says McBain. "I'll leave it to you. As soon as we rescue Ms. Aria, we'll escape right onto Marcia with her. I don't think we'll be able to return to Cavara, so we'll have to say goodbye here." "Mr. McBain, thank you for everything," says Maritos. DeMille says, "We promise you we'll get rid of the numerous army before too long without fail. Please come back to relax soon." "We'll be back for next year's concert for sure," says Forte. "That is right," McBain says. "We'll see you soon." "Well, I believe that's it. Now we're going outside to attract the audience. It'll be troublesome if your acquainted soldiers find you. Please hide behind the entrance or somewhere." "All right," says Palman. "Good. Let's get our operation started." DeMille says, "Well, we'll proceed with the preparation inside then." "Thank you for doing that," Maritos says. "No problem," McBain says. "You can count on us." "I'll be waiting for the right moment inside," Palman says. "Okay." "All right, let's start gathering the people." "Okay, we are ready," says Forte. "We're good," says Una. "Woof! Squeak!" "Ready. Go. Start gathering the people." "Come on and take a look," says Una. "It's all at bargain prices," says Forte. "Everything must go." This is not a flea market. It's a concert. Bow wow. Squeak squaw. Hmm? What are we doing? "Oops," says Forte. "Do start over." McBain says, "Ready. Go. Start gathering the people." Una yells, "We're opening the door for the special concert. Presented by our diva Wendy," says Forte. "And Cavaro Trio," says McBain. Una says, "A fascinating performance of Stardust Cantata. Please enjoy," says Forte. "Don't miss it," says McBain. "Woof, woof. Eep, eep." "Perfect," says McBain. "Considering that you're saying perfect, no one's gathering at all," says Forte. Una says, "We distributed all the invitations, and everyone should know it's free, but how come no one's coming?" "You can't hear us from here?" McBain says, "It's difficult to get people to come into such an event until the first person comes and starts making a flow of people." "Huh. The same thing will happen to us when we hold a concert, too." "I see," says Forte. "If we perform in front of the theater, the people may start to come in." "Oh, okay. That's it," says Una. "Let's try that," McBain says. Traveler's Prelude. Thank you. Oh, you're getting down, says a soldier. Since this city is famous for the music, the people perform in order to gather the audience, too. Yeah, something like that. We did it, Grandpa. Continue playing. Like the city of art the Cavaro is, they do nice things. Okay, just doing something. Oh, here they all come. Commander Xenon says, "How freakish." I didn't expect the International Theater to be like this. I thought it would value more dignity. That's Commander Xenon, says Forte. Jeez. He entered the theater. The prey is in the birdcage now. We'll leave the rest to canaries, says McBean. Are you talking in code? Here's Palman. We confirm that Commander Xenon has taken his seat. It sounds like the concert has started, says Forte. Okay, let's start with what we are supposed to do, says McBean. We can't lose time in rescuing. Let's hurry to the city hall. I'm so unlucky that I have to stay here when others are having fun at the International Theater, the soldier says. You are Captain Palman? Thank you for standing guard. Well done. Aren't you going to the theater? Well, I was left with the duty here. I'm sorry, do you have a concert ticket? Yes, I do have a concert ticket, but... Okay, I'll fill in for you. Commander Xenon is in the theater anyway. I don't think the whole army can do any work today. Are you sure? I'm not interested in music. Enjoy. Thank you very much. Please don't tell Commander Xenon about this. He's hopping. Hooray! I kind of feel bad, says Forte. Get going, Palman says. Yeah, get going. So I'm saving here. Because I'm wondering... What happens if we do something else? Okay, well, we can't go that way. It's not letting us. Did the grandma and grandpa go to the concert? They're not in there. Hey, I want to go to the concert. Oh, is everyone at the concert? The bread man's gone, too. Oh, I can't go upstairs. Ah! Interesting. I'm just messing around, seeing what's possible. Oh! No guard stopping us, but we can't go. Curious. The same here. Where am I? Oh. There's nothing in-game from stopping us from leaving the city or going into the other area, but they blocked it off. There's only one place to go. Who the heck are you? How did you come in? Through the front door? You are... Oh boy. Did he kill that guy? Did he run him through with a spear? What, a sword? It looks like a spear he's holding. Sorry, says Palman. Well, okay. We have another issue of Kavara Times. Huh. The Kavara Times, we cannot help but feel anger towards the numerous army which has occupied Kavara, under the pretext of eradicating the Wood Soldiers. According to our own investigation, odds are that the attack of the Wood Soldiers was plotted by the numerous army itself. We should have a united effort to cancel the martial law and drive the numerous army from our land. The freedom of the citizens of Kavara must be protected at all times. We, the employees of the Kavara Times, are prepared for a do-or-die resistance with our pens, regardless of whether the newspaper is to be banned. Wow, that's heavy stuff. Alright, so there's nobody in here. Let's see, but these books are inaccessible now for some reason. Oh, she's in there. Oh, I can't... Intruder? Ooh, bashing him around. McBain says now. The door is locked. This should be it, says Palman. Aria, say something if you're inside. Woo! I thought she only sang, who are you? Ah, she responded, says Una. We're here to help, Forte says. Miss Aria, can you hear me? We don't have time to find a key, says Una. Alright, have Grandpa bust the door open. We don't have time, says McBain. I can easily break this door open with one punch. Go ahead. Oh, yeah, says Forte. Was he doing the Kool-Aid Man? How about that, huh? Says McBain. I feel sorry towards Mayor DeMille for breaking the door, says Una. Oh, come on, it's a door versus a human being's life. Come on, hurry, says McBain. Palman. Who are you? She says. We don't have time, says McBain. I'll tell you later. Altos whispering, I wonder if Mr. McBain succeeded. Oh no, the concert's already over, says McBain. Let's hurry, Palman says. They're back here, says Forte. They came back earlier than I thought, McBain says. Don't worry, Palman says. Come this way. Forte says, this is Miss Meritos. Palman says, securing the escaping route is my job. You can climb up on the elevated walkway from the back of Miss Meritos' room. If you go above the waterway, you won't encounter the soldiers. I see, says McBain. You noticed a good thing. Come on and hurry, says Palman. Palman locked from inside. We should be able to buy some time. Aria says, who in the world? Why did you risk your life for me? McBain says, I just couldn't see you get captured for no reason. I want to ask you the same question. Tell me, says Palman. You came to occupied Kavaro, heedless of danger to heal the people. Why did you do such a thing to true attention? I had known that the Numeros was interested in my power and wanted to capture me. But my mission is to heal people who I can to help. I don't understand, says Palman. You won't be able to fulfill your mission if you lose your own life. You may be satisfied, but do you think someone who you rescued would be happy if he found out that you lost your life because of him? I'm sorry. I don't mean to blame you. No, I was careless, she says. I just got carried away with the people in this town. Palman says, from here, Mr. McBain will lead you way out. I'll become bait. But it's too dangerous, says Una. She is right, says Forte. I'll be fine. I'm confident that I can escape from any circumstance. You need to leave Cavaro as soon as possible. You can get to the exit onto Marcha in the northwest of the town if you go above the elevated walkway. Waterway. You have to switch the waterway only once. You'll know when you get there. You better escape before Commander Xenon settles. We'll have no chance to get out if the exit from the town is closed. If we both manage to get away, we will have a chance to meet again someday, somewhere. So long. Mr. Palman, says Aria. Thanks. When I heard about your rumor, he says, I thought we should not breathe on you with the worldly grime if you really had the power. What? I heard about your rumor. I thought we should not breathe on you with the worldly grime. Okay, that's you lost me there. I want to live my life honestly to do what I thought. Alright, see you later with the worldly grime. Okay, let's get going, says Forte. Excuse me. Sorry about that. That's cool, we're up here. Oh, over there, says a soldier, or solider. There they are, above the waterway. They found us, says Una. Saving separate file. So I want to save this one because we can read the Cavaro times, because now it's inaccessible. What if I go this way? We won't let you get away with this. They surrounded us, says Forte. What should we do, says Una. Fight? Oh. What? She says. We've got the boomerangs. Blonde youth. That's not Avon and Mile, is it? It looks like Avon and Mile. From Materia Vermilion. The target is the soldier, right? Says a blonde youth. Youth with... Friggin' Avon! Youth with bandana. Don't ask after you threw it. I can't believe it was Avon and Mile. I know, but just to make sure. Do you think it's acceptable for us to interfere with this matter? Well, we can't just ignore it, can we? Says Bandana Kid. That way next. You're right. Our ally? Says Palman. How did they get over here? To this part of the world? So, Avon, I guess, says, good, we gotta get out of here, too. Oh, they're from the, standing on the International Theater. What was that flying? Says Una. It looked like a boomerang, says Forte. No doubt that they lent us a hand, McBain says. Thank God, let's get away. So we were supposed to go that way? Because I was just playing around. I figured we were supposed to go this way. Well, the way we didn't go. Alright, I'm gonna explore around. Well, we can't get through there. So that's where it would have led us. It would have been a dead end with that. Yeah. Kind of a dead end, right? Except there's that other way up there. Sorry if I'm driving you guys insane. I'm just seeing, I like to see where we can go and where we can't go. Yeah, that's a dead end there. This is our first time exploring this waterway here. So at some point we have to switch the waterway. And we'll know when that's supposed to happen. Oh! He's hanging out. You gonna give us some bread on the way? I knew you would come. Headman Matthews, says Forte. They were saying that you were running away through the waterway. Come on up here. McBean says, I see. This is how it worked. Thank you. Thanks, says Una. Be careful, says Matthew. So the way it was originally... Headman Matthew, thank you for everything. Don't waste your time thanking me. I'll feed you a belly full of chestnut bread next time, so come back again. Oh boy, I think Palman's outnumbered. Listen, the citizens of Cavaro. The wood soldiers which attacked this town were released by the numerous army. Don't talk nonsense, says the solider. The brothers and sisters of Numeros, listen to my words. It was all plotted by Commander Xenon. Who's right behind you? Are you losing your mind, Palman? Commander Xenon, I'm as conscious as ever. You're the one who strayed out of the path of righteousness and lost your mind. Kill him!